incoming cadets. I'm Cadet McCarthy in AS300.
And I'm Cadet Farrather in AS300, and today we're going to be giving you a tour of the life of a cadet at the University of Maryland. Our first stop today is the parking lot located between the hotel and CP Hall. Cadets arriving by car should arrive between 0500 and 0520. After parking, make sure to put a piece of paper that has ROTC written in large bold letters on it, placed visibly on the dash. This will show that you have paid for parking and will make sure you are not ticketed.
All right, our next stop is the armory.
This
is the armory. Almost all of your Air Force ROTC activities are going to happen here unless you're specified otherwise.
There are 5 entrances to the armory, 2 on each side and then 1 on the front. Cadets will enter through this side of the building.
The next stop is the cadre offices. As soon as you enter our main doors, you'll find all cadre offices right here on the left.
The offices of each of the cadre can be found behind this door, as well as our administrative assistant, Ms. Rich.
In order to gain access to the offices, you just have to press this little button right here.
Next stop's the armored courts. And this is the armored courts.
All GNC cadets need to be in the armored courts by 0550 prior to lead lab unless specified otherwise.
Lead lab starts at 0600 and runs until 0830. Some events you can expect to see inside the armory courts is drill, group leadership projects, open rank inspections, and morale events. Right. Peace.
The next place we're going is the classrooms. Located here in the armory, there are 3 classrooms that we utilize for our activities. We have 0131 right here.
This is 0135.
And then lastly, we have 0126.
Room 0126 is used during every single lead lab. We use it for the commander's minute, announcements, guest speakers. There's also a chance that your air science classes will be taking place in one of these 3 classrooms.
Now for some more rooms in the armory.
This is our heritage room. It's kind of our main cadet lounge here at the detachment.
Heritage room, cadets will meet here before lead lab to plan and get ready with their flights, but you're also free to come here anytime to do homework, study, and prepare for your extracurriculars.
Inside the heritage room, we also have 3 flight simulators that all cadets can use as long as they have permission from the pilot training officer.
This is the bar. Cadets utilize this to study and socialize, and right over here we have a little snack shack area. Just make sure you pay for what you get. And we also have a fridge right behind the camera, which is normally stacked full of caffeine.
And over here, we have cubbies that are available for all cadets to use to store all of their goods that they might have ready for lead lab. Next is UO. Always be sure to ring the bell for service.
So in the UO, you can pick up all of your PTGs, OCPs, SDUs, and your patches. Make sure you sign up to be a UO tech. It's a really great opportunity.
2 of our biggest extracurriculars here at DET 330 are the Maryland Honor Guard and the Arnold Air Society.
Hey everyone, my name is Cadet Patnod. I'm an AS400 and I'm the Mission Support Group Commander, and my advice to you all is that you can do anything you put your mind to.
All right, good morning everyone. I'm Cadet Matthews, the Maryland Honor Guard Commander for this semester. One piece of advice that I have is just be better than we were yesterday. Don't compare yourself to the other one, anyone else, and then just only compare yourself to who you were yesterday and how you progressed.
Hi everyone, my name is Cadet Wolf. I'm an AS200. I'm the Wing XO, and my advice for everyone is put yourself out there. Take up that job that you're thinking of taking. Take up that responsibility, put yourself out there.
I'm Cadet Hill, and a way I recommend to thrive in Air Force ROTC is to manage your time well and meet people.
Hey, whoever's watching this video, Cadet Reyes, I'm an AS400. I'm a 47 squadron commander, and my one piece of advice, don't suck.